Can you shush? It's so loud for everybody else. And nobody's making a sound, honey. All right, let me put this in, and I gotta put this microphone over here so that people at home can hear. Ryan, honey, have a seat on your bottom, please. All right, I will come and grab the book.
This is the story of Mickey Mouse and his spooky Halloween party. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it's time to turn the page when you hear a chime, like this. Let's begin now. Mickey Mouse looked around his living room. It was decorated with ghosts, spiders, and bats. A jack-o'-lantern smiled at him from the mantelpiece.
I am gonna have a great Halloween party tonight.
Mickey tacked one last fake cobweb to the wall.
Now it's time to make the popcorn balls.
Mickey went to the kitchen and began making some popcorn. Then he noticed something moving around in the yard. He picked up a candle and opened the door slowly. Mickey looked around. The moon was out and it was windy. The branches and leaves were making strange shadows.
Gosh, I'm just being silly.
He went back inside. Mickey glanced at the clock.
It's almost time for the party, and I haven't gotten ready yet. Now, where did I put that old pirate costume?
Mickey went upstairs. Then he went up, up, up a ladder into the dark attic. As soon as he switched on the light, thunder crashed. Lightning flashed across the sky. As Mickey looked around, he noticed something tall in the corner. He crept closer. A large, ghostly shadow fell over him.
Hello?
Lightning flashed again, and Mickey saw the thing he'd been scared of. It was a coat rack with a sheet over it. Mickey went over to an old trunk.
I'll bet my pirate costume's in here.
He brushed off the dust, but there was so much that it tickled his nose and he sneezed.
Achoo!
Mickey turned the key in the rusty old lock and opened the trunk. A skeleton popped out. Mickey jumped back. Then he realized it was just a plastic party decoration.
Phew! Guess that was a Halloween joke on me! This skeleton will be perfect for my party!
Mickey rummaged around.
I'd better take the whole trunk downstairs. There's a lot of cool Halloween stuff in here.
Meanwhile, in Mickey's backyard, Pluto was chasing a ball this way and that. As he charged under the clothesline, one of the sheets came loose from the line and fell on him. It covered him from head to tail. Suddenly, rain began to fall. The wet sheet stuck to Pluto like glue. He ran all over the yard, but no matter how hard he tried, he couldn't shake it off, and he couldn't see anything either. Donald Duck, Goofy, Minnie Mouse, and Daisy Duck drove up to Mickey's house. Goofy peered out the window.
Gosh, look at the lightning!
Daisy giggled nervously.
Oh, it's a very spooky Halloween night.
But Minnie had a plan.
Let's run right into the house.
The thunder and lightning went crazy as Mickey's friends hurried inside.
Mickey, we're here!
But there was no answer. Mickey was too far upstairs to hear anything over the sounds of the storm. Just then, the lights went out. Then Mickey's friends heard weird thumping sounds above them. Minnie gasped.
What was that?
Something big and heavy was being dragged across the floor upstairs.
It sounds like a coffin being dragged across Mickey's room.
Now Donald was getting nervous. Between the storm, the dark, and the noises, it felt a little like they were in a haunted house. Up in the attic, Mickey stopped dragging the trunk around and decided to look for a flashlight. He walked into a huge cobweb.
Yikes! These spider webs are all over the place!
Finally, he found a candle and some matches. Meanwhile, in the backyard, poor Pluto was still stuck under the sheet. He couldn't see to find his doggy door. From inside, Daisy looked around.
What's that sound?
Just then, something weird and white ran past the window. Goofy gasped. Daisy stared in surprise.
It's a ghost!
Mickey's friends were too scared even to scream. By then, Mickey had changed into his pirate costume. He slowly headed down the dark staircase, carrying the skeleton. Mickey's friends heard shuffling feet and rattling bones. They looked up to see a horrible monster coming toward them. They hid behind a chair. Suddenly, the lights came back on. Mickey realized his friends were there.
Gosh, are you dead?
Minnie smiled.
Oh, Mickey, it's just you. You really scared us.
Was that your ghost?
Yes, that's one very scary costume.
Daisy pointed to the hook on Mickey's hand. Daisy picked up a cupcake and smiled.
Mickey, this is the scariest, most exciting Halloween ever. How did you do it?
Yeah, Mickey, it's the best haunted house I've ever been in.
Haunted house?
A puzzled Mickey looked around. Just then, Pluto found his way in through the doggy door. He ran into the living room. Mickey and his friends looked up and saw a ghost. And boy, did they scream. Then Mickey realized it wasn't a ghost.
Oh, Pluto, it's just you. Hey, boy, you're all wet. Let's get you dried off.
Mickey dried Pluto with a towel and smiled at his friends.
You know, with all of those ghost shadows and noises, this is the scariest Halloween ever.
All right. Did you guys enjoy that story? No. So, Mitchell, the kids found this story in the library, and they really wanted to read it. It's about Mickey's spooky Halloween party, but it really wasn't spooky, was it? No. When the lights went off, why did the lights go off? Raise your hand. Why did the lights go off, Tamia? Because of the rain, yeah. It was storming, and so when there's a storm, sometimes your power goes out, right?
Yeah.
And who was making all that howling outside? Prince. Pluto the dog. Yeah, he was howling because he couldn't see, because he had that sheet stuck to him, and it was raining, so the sheet was stuck on him, and he couldn't get it off. And when the friends walked in the house, they heard creepy noises upstairs. Were those really creepy noises?
No.
No. Who was that upstairs?
Mickey.
And he was dragging that big chest that he found, right? Up in the closet with all of the rest of his decorations. So was this even scary?
No.
They were just being goofy. Oh, well, Goofy is also a person in the story. My sweets, it is time for us to eat. Your lunches have arrived. They will be delicious. Let's fold our hands to pray. Mitchell, we will see you later, sweetheart, for math at noon in an hour. Bye, my sweet.